Blade speed is the easy way to quickly capture the beat where the video has already been edited. And if you follow the steps, you'll have your video cut to the beat in no time flat. There are so many reasons to use the blade speed feature. Let's look at just one that will give you an idea of how it works. Let's assume you have a music track and you want to set the changes in the video track to the beat of the music. This will involve changing the video portion to match the beats in the music. The method works best with frequent significant beats. First, put your video in the main storyline. If this is made up of multiple clips, edit them into a completed story before you add your music. And if you don't want any audio from the original video, select Video Only. Select the clips in the browser and press the E key. Edit the length of the clips and make any color corrections that you may need, or add effects if you want to. Anyway, this can be modified later if you want. Select all the clips in the timeline and make a compound clip. Turn off the video only and replace with all. Bring your audio clip into timeline by pressing the E key. Position the compound clip above the part of the music track that you want to use. You need to start to blade cut from the beginning of the clip. It will not work if you start from the end of the video and work backwards. Adjust the height of the clips of the timeline. Place your playhead at the beginning of the compound clip and zoom in with the keys Command Plus. Hover the skipper to the change in scenes that you want on a beat. And once you're close to the change, use the left and right arrow keys to have it perfect. And you need to have the first frame of the new scene showing in the viewer window. This is important. Make sure the video clip is selected, yellow outlines. Select blade speed. Now look in the music track for the closest significant beat. The higher the beat or the stronger the beat, the better. For accuracy, select the music track and move the playhead to the beat point. Press the M key. After you've got familiar with this function, you may not need to add that marker in future. Select the video track. You'll see a grayed area and a black vertical line. This is the bladed point. Click on the black vertical and drag it to the marker. Press the L key until you see the next scene change. Use the arrow key to get to the first frame of the cut after the viewer. This time press Shift plus B. This is the keyboard shortcut for speed blade. And this time, a quicker way to use than a marker is to drag the playhead to the beat point. Now drag the black vertical over the beat point. You'll see a little white triangle. Position the black vertical so it shows in the middle of that white triangle. And the dark areas in the video are the audio fades between the two clips. This means that the speed of the video as it transitions from the cut point. You can drag these edges to increase or decrease the speed transitions for a hard cut or a softer cut. Hover the playhead to the next scene change, or use the L key to move forward. You could also use the space key. Use the arrow keys to get the scene after the cut. Make sure that's showing in the viewer. Press Shift B. Drag the black vertical line over the beat points. And now you want to repeat all these changes on each beat. Now I'll play the completed edit that's been cut to the beat. done so already, please like, subscribe, and press the bell.